Yeah, so I hope you have seen this material on the Moodle course page. So we are moving on to the next topic, which is on the JSON, JavaScript object notation. So before we move on to this, let me hear from you about the XML. So I'll just try to interact with you now. So, what is the structure in which your XML data is getting stored, please?
So a tree structure.
Very good. So Kulshrestha is basically your XML, not only XML. Now the topic which we are going to understand is on the JSON, which is also stores your data in the form of a tree structure. So why we are going for that tree structure? What is the reason behind it? Anybody? Anyone, please?
Easy to, very good structure to organize the data.
Easy to?
Organize the data.
Organize the data. Easy to organize the data is an incomplete answer. Can you please elaborate a little bit, Raghavendra?
Easy to understand, we can say.
Easy to understand.
Parsing. Yes.
Better to, easy to identify the tag which we are currently using.
Easy to identify, easy to understand, easy to organize. Yeah, any more answers, please? Before we move on, I think there are some more people are getting joined. So anyway, so before we move on, let me just put the things in another way. So I hope you are able to see my Word file. I'm just starting a Word application here. Can you see my Word file here now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So suppose if I am organizing in this structured manner, what is this basically? This structure is the structure which I'm using here.
Tabular form.
A table form. Very simple, a table form here. Suppose I am going to put some values here, x, y, something like radius, or something like another one is something like label. Okay. I'm just filling up some values here. Kindly hold on, just let me put some values. We assume that there are some values like this. This is basically a tabular form of data storage. Data has been stored or data has been organized in this particular structured manner. Now your answers, some of you are given that earlier you are given the answers such as easy to understand, easy to organize, easy to tag it. Now can't we easy to understand here? About some information here, something like x, y, the radius and the label. Is it not easy to understand? Is it not easy to organize? Is it not something like in this form of structure of organizing the data? My question is that, are you able to understand the question?
Sir, by using tree structure, we can easily divide the categories into subcategories.
Sorry, can you please, who is this?
Dina, sir, actually, in tree structure, we can easily divide the categories into subcategories.
So the tree structure, the advantage of tree structure is to have something called subcategories. Yeah, you have rightly pointed out. See here, carefully, suppose instead of this one, Let me just, maybe the data is inappropriate for you. Something like, I will say something like this, city, something like Hyderabad, Delhi, and so on and so forth, something like this. Please, I have something like this, Hyderabad, maybe something like 25 degrees centigrade or 30 degrees centigrade on Tuesday, or something like 35 degrees. So Delhi 30, 32, 37, and I 35, something like this. If suppose the data is organized, this is basically your temperature data. Temperature of a particular city on a particular day, or this is a maximum temperature, you can say is maximum set of values. Assume like that. So here, what happened is you are able to, these are your maximum values on a particular day, maximum temperature value. Assume that it is only a maximum temperature value. Suppose if you want to write a minimum temperature value, what is that you are going to do? You are going to construct another table with minimum temperature. Similarly, if you want to have an average temperature value, you are going to prepare another table with the average temperature values of so-and-so city on a particular day. Like this, if you keep on adding more structures, more data structures, or more the organized form for something like maximum temperature, one particular table, minimum temperature is another particular table, average temperature is another particular table, something like that, it is going to be a hell lot of structures if you are going to prepare like that. So it will be difficult to organize, in other terms difficult to access the data, in other terms difficult to manipulate the data, in other terms difficult to access, control the information or manage the information across this web pages. So if you organize the data in a flat table, these tables are called as flat data. This is flat data. What is meant by flat data? Your data is organized in a table form. That is basically you call it as a flat data. So now if you put the same kind of information or the same kind of data which is to be organized in a different form, suppose you put it in a hierarchical manner, something like this. If I put something in the form of a tree structure. So here, let me just put something. So you have a tree structure. Let me suppose we have a tree structure here. On the root node, we have something called as a weather. And from here, if you are now trying to add something as a children or a something like this, suppose you are adding another, the weather of a particular city. So here you are going to add one more city here. So you are going to add a hierarchical structure here, something like this. This is Hyderabad, and you are going to further come down with so many other things here now. So like this, you are basically you are creating a hierarchical structure here. So again, in the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, again for each day you can have a corresponding hierarchical structure here. So again on Monday you can have what is the maximum. So here, what is that you have done is, if you look to this both the diagrams carefully, of course I have not completed the diagram. Now, if you see here, which is more advantageous, the flat data or your hierarchical structured data? When you organize the data for a web page, so we are our process is what is the, our context here is, we are going to make the availability of the data. Which is to be organized in such a way that the web page, when the information is displayed on the web page or on the web content, that web content can be easily accessible, it can be easily manipulated, it can be easily controllable, and it can be easily used, or it can be easily understood. And another term is, of course, the understanding of the data is also important here. So a human readable understanding here. So if you see on the top side, the first figure, it is basically a tabular data, which is in the flat data. Basically, we call it as a flat data organization in the tabular form. So here, this particular table is only indicating you a temperature of a maximum value. Of course, if you want to again depict, or if you want to store the minimum values on so-and-so dates, on so-and-so day for a particular city, then you have to prepare another table. But if you organize the entire information, something like that, the root node as a weather and followed by the different cities, you can make this for different cities also similarly. So all those things have been maintained under the web page. So here under the root node as a weather. So here that this type of organization is going to be more useful than the flat data type, as especially for your web pages. I may know the reason. Of course, I have given the reason for you, but I would like to hear from you now. What are the other advantages that you can foresee or you can understand from this hierarchical representation of your weather data? If this weather data is to be displayed on a web page or on the web web application. Hello, am I audible to you, please?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Can you please tell me this second type is hierarchical data, hierarchical way of organizing the data, which is, I say, which is more advantageous than the flat data organization for a web application. Why? What is the reason behind?
Sir, we can easily access or we can store the data.
See, let me, yeah, easily access and easily store. These are very general terms. I would like to hear more specifically and more technical terms for our web application with the knowledge whatever you have gained so far. I am expecting that answer, please.
Sir, we can also save space by saving it in a tree structure rather than a flat file structure.
We can minimize the space, or you can save the space. See, this space, easy to understand, means easy to access the data. These are very generic answers. Still, I'm expecting a more clarity. If not more technically, please tell me in your own words. I'll put for the question in another way. Suppose this is your weather web page. This is a weather, means you want to know what is the weather. So you will be opening, you will be creating a web application or a web page showing the weather conditions of our different cities. So you assume that that is the situation and that is the scenario now. Now let me know. I want to hear more answers from you, please. Because you know the answer, that's what I'm expecting.
Good readability.
Readability, understandability, all comes into the same category, Baba.
Sir, can you please repeat the question, like what are you exactly asking?
I am repeating the question again. So there is a web page. The web page gives you information about the weather conditions in a city, of a city or whatever you like to have. If you are looking for a weather condition of a particular city, you will get that information from a web page. And that web page is presenting the data of these particular different cities, where the data is internally organized in a structured manner, that basically that structure is a hierarchical structure rather than a flat file data structure. I'm asking, the question is, what is that advantage that you gain or get from this hierarchical organization of this data?
Sir, modification of structure is easier in a tree data structure than a flat data structure, like that in a file.
So coordination of data. You are on the track, sir, that's what, sir, I'm expecting. Yes, please.
Sir, connecting two tables is a little bit different, or it little bit difficult, but in a tree structure it can be multi-level and will be very easy to like dig deeper into the pages that we are looking for.
So the answers of these two students who has given, now you have to combine and get me the correct answer. Now both of them have given the 50-50% answers. One of them given the coordination, another them has given the connecting. Connecting with the tables is going to be different. So the answers are in this track only, in this thought process. So I would like to hear the other students' thought process here. You can combine these two students' answers in a proper way, you will get a more appropriate answer. Okay. Any more views, please? Any more idea? Any more answers?
Tree structure gives more modularity.
Modularity, yes, acceptable. See, most of the time, one thing I think you are, one more important thing that you are missing here is, see, the application here is what I have given is a weather application, okay? So in this weather application, what happens is this weather data is going to be collected by whom? Most of the time you are telling that we are able to see, we are able to understand, we are able to read it, we are able to make it. But the answer is not in the we actually. Can you please tell me where exactly you are going to use this weather web page information here? Now I will put this question in a more clarity way. Let me just put here. Can you see my screen, please?
Yes, sir.
Hello, are you able to see my screen now?
Yes, sir. Yes,
okay, sir. Now, yes, please see here. I assume that now this is one weather website is here. So in this weather.com is the website. Now, if you see this hierarchy here carefully, it is in English and in India. So something like you are getting your weather information over here. Now tell me what is that you are going to gain if you are going to organize that weather information in a particular hierarchical structure manner. If you see here carefully also, weather.com, English weather, 10 day, Gachibowli Indoor Stadium. Of course, this is a latitude, longitude, okay, date is given, India. Sometimes some other websites will give you latitude, longitude, the exact location, so on and so forth. They give this information. What is that you're going, what is, my question here is, what is that you're going to do with this data now? Some other web applications make use of this data, or you are going to write your own programs for your effective data analysis or data processing. You will collect this information here from this website or from this resource or from this web resource or web website. So in order to collect that information, if the information is organized in this hierarchical manner, then the other web applications or your other codes that you are going to write it, for that it will be useful for them to collect the data and retrieve the data and give the data to the requested person very easily, rather than collecting the data from these tables where the data is stored in different multiple tables or different ways where the data is located and so on and so forth. I hope you are able to understand the point what I'm trying to address here. Are you clear with this point or not? If you organize the data in a hierarchical manner, it will be easy to fetch or retrieve the data by going through different sub-levels or by going through sub-categories, whatever you call it as, by going through different levels from the parent to child, child to sub-child, subchild to another subchild, or like this. By another application, it will be easy for them to retrieve the data or search the data, or searching the data is also going to be there. Of course, in this small example, it is only with two different cities. It is not a complete diagram. You can see the number of cities now in your on your web page. It will be more in number. Searching, retrieving, updating, collection is going to be very, is not going to be a trivial task if your data is organized in this particular flat data format. That's why this hierarchical organization of the data is the most important aspect, and that is being taken by our web technologists, that is being handled by our web technologists in this particular two topics. One is your XML, another is your JSON format. So last week we discussed about XML. Are you clear with this XML? Any queries here, please, related to XML? What does XML stands for, please?
extensible markup language, sir.
Right. So how do you verify whether your extensible markup language has got a well-formed formula or well-formed statements or not? Well-formed instructions of your XML or not? How do you verify it? How do you check the syntax of XML? Yeah.
By writing the schema of the XML.
By writing the?
Schema, XML schema.
Schema, right? XML schema. That is called as? That is called as? What is the name? So you're not, in last week's class you have not gone through, many of you. There are two ways actually. One is, of course he has given the answer, that is your schema, but that has been termed as XSD. XSD. What you have to, please, you need to understand what is XSD abbreviation, please. What is the full form of that?
XML schema definition.
Very good. What is another way? What is another way through which you can check your XML is well formed or not?
So DTD.
DTD. What is DTD stands for?
So document type.
Document type definition. Yes, document type definition. So have you understood those two topics? How do you? Of course, I have given with some websites, applications also, where you can type your HTML file and get the corresponding XML. Whether it XMLs are well formatted or not. So you have not tried those exercises. So please try for this, and you need to complete as quickly as possible. Otherwise, you'll be pending all the tasks till the last minute. There won't be any use. Okay, let me move on to this next topic. So we'll start with Jason. So introduction to JavaScript object notation, JSON, it stands for. So in this session, we'll try to understand JSON syntax, reading JSON from a server, JSON parsing, and JSON objects and arrays. Of course, please remember XML and JSON, after my completing this topic, it doesn't mean that both the topics are completed. No, since we have not started the server side scripting, we will not be appreciating how best your XML HTTP request and how to fetch the data from the server side, from the server to the client. So that particular topic is going to be still pending. Once I start the server processing, then we'll come back to this JSON and XML again. So please do remember that you are not completing these topics at this time only. Just an introduction of all these things. So later you'll understand how your XML and JSON are going to fetch data from the server, and it is going to be given to your clients, means the requested web pages. So it is easy to fetch the data, and how the data is getting fetched, what are the methods, and how that process takes place is what, after AJAX and after server-side scripting, you will come to know. So at this point, because I'm going with the sequence of the syllabus, so this is introduction to JSON is there here at this moment. Okay, JSON is, yeah, any queries, please, for anyone? Okay, so JSON is a syntax for storing and exchanging data, which is very much similar to XML also. XML is also a syntax for storing and exchanging data. So if you might have seen the last week's discussion, see, this is one example of an XML file where different books information, books data. There is a book, the title Learning XML. There is another book titled Learning Python. There is another book titled Java Servlets Programming, like this. Each book information is now stored in a particular manner, in a hierarchical manner, to be very specific. So here the bookstore is the parent. So under the parent, or you can call it as a root tag or a parent tag. Under this parent tag, you have a child tag called book, and there are different childs of the same parent bookstore. So this is another book. So this is the details about that. Title of the book, author, who is the author, and year and price. So you are giving this the information. This information is put in between the tags. So there is an opening tag and there is a corresponding closing tag. So in this way, this is the information which has been structured or organized in this particular hierarchical manner, and this form is this hierarchical organizations is to be termed as an XML, because you are extending the actual markup language, that is to your tags. You are extending your user defined tags here. It means user defined tags are being used in addition to your existing HTML tags too. Of course, this is just a snippet of that particular code here, what you are understanding here. So along with the values, you are giving the corresponding tags to here. So now once you organize the data in this XML format, which is easy to store it, of course, organization. Of course, the same thing can be used to exchange the information. So the exchange means you are sending the data, or you are retrieving the data, or you are going to transport the data from one web page to another web page, or from a server to a client, or from the client to a server. It means you are exchanging the data between two different applications, or between two different systems, or two different scenarios where some kind of information exchange is taking place. Where this information exchange is taking place, it is a human readable understanding. Human can easily understand. At the same time, the machines which are exchanging that information can also understand, and that particular easy representation is being used. So this is what you have seen in the last week. That is basically using your XML. But now we have another format where it is also meant for storing and exchanging the data. But this particular format is basically a lightweight data interchange format. Please remember, this is very lightweight as compared to XML. So XML is going to be somewhat, we call it as a heavyweight, whereas JSON is going to be very lightweight. So why exactly this is to be called, or this is termed as a lightweight? Let us see in the, after some examples we see it. So this in JSON, we also write the text, which is along with the JavaScripts basically. So this is a text is written with the JavaScript object notation. And of course, you can convert any JavaScript object into JSON, that is JavaScript object notation format, and thus convert JSON to either and send the data to your server, so that you can stringify that object and you can send it to the server. Stringify means you have, that is what the conversion process is. Similarly, you can also receive the data from the server in a particular form to the corresponding JavaScript objects or to the corresponding web pages. So how do you write this JSON, or what is the syntax? So JSON syntax is derived from the JavaScript object notation syntax. It is a subset of JavaScript syntax itself. So the actual in the syntax where your data is been stored and it is been represented, so that it will be represented in the form of key value pairs. So the key can be called as an attribute. So attribute value, for every attribute there will be a corresponding value. So that is a combination, key value, key corresponding value. It is a pair of two things. One is the key, which is going to be called as an attribute or a property, and the other thing is basically a value, which is separated by colons. So here data is separated by commas. You can use multiple data items to be separated, and now you need to put this key value pairs within the flowering braces, this flowering open flower brace and a closing flower brace. If you see this example, so there is an open flowering brace where inside you have two different values here, so the which is separated by a colon. So the before to the colon is what is basically the key. So this is what your key. You can call it as an attribute, you can call it as an characteristic, you can call it as a property. And what is this NKS? NKS is the value of that particular key. That's why this is called key value, which has been given in terms of the open flower brace and the closing flower brace. So notice that in JavaScript, keys can be strings, it can be numbers, or it can be identifier names. So a pure JavaScript object will be simply you give the value to that object. Otherwise, here if you are giving the quotations along with the open flower brace and closing flower brace, basically this notation, that is what JavaScript object notation. An object having certain properties and their corresponding values are stored in this particular structure. That's what your JSON structure is. So what are these values? A JSON must be one of the following data types. It can be a string, it can be an object, or it can be an array, or it can be a boolean, or without any value, there is simply a null value. So if you see it on the right side, if you see this is a book, So book is equal to open flower brace. So you are giving an object, book object. This book object has got different attributes. Those attributes are your title, author, year, and price. So those corresponding attributes, you have corresponding values. So what is the value of this title? What is the author value? The authors, there are multiple authors. There are two authors with this book. Similarly, for this year, what is the value? Similarly, for the price, what is the price of that book? So this book object has got different keys, and each key has got a corresponding value. So you represent that particular object information in terms of this book object with an open floor brace and a closing floor brace. This type of notation is basically called as a JSON notation. So to access an object value, use the you can access this particular values of these attributes using the object name with a dot member operator. So this member operator dot will enable you to access this corresponding attribute or this particular property or this particular key. So you can use it through dot operator, or you can use it through your index key representation with the name itself in the square braces with the quotation quotes. The file type of a JSON file is .json. So always, if you are representing the objects in this form, so that particular file will have an extension of .json format. And the MIME type for JSON text is applications/JSON. That's what the internet, the exchange format, internet mail exchange format, which is going to be there. So what is the MIME type for XML, please? Hello, am I audible to you?
.xml.
Yeah, it is not a .xml, that is application/XML usually. So what is the purpose of MIME type to be specified in the script file? What is that it goes, what is that it indicates for us? In other terms, why we write in our codes like this application/json, application/XML, application/script, application/JavaScript, something like that. Why do we write here like this? application/something, like what is the format that the following set of lines of code indicate?
It indicates that the what type of code is written in that file.
Yes, it is indicates what type of code. Is it for our is it for the developer or the user purpose, or it for the machine purpose? Machine or your browser or your client or
browser.
Your server
purpose. For the browser.
Yes. Browser.
Yes, for it is for the browser, not for the user or for the developer or for the person who is writing the code. It is for the engine. Engine means the processing engine. Who is going to check this one? Basically, when you write this statement, the first person who is going to check it will be on your browser. That browser has got an engine. That is the software to check. So that fellow will check this particular, what is the notation that is going to be followed for the following set of instructions. So now let us see some of the differences between JSON and XML. Both JSON and XML can be used to receive data from the web servers. Yes, if your information is present on a web server, some on some other computer, so it will be easy for you to retrieve that information. So using, how do you retrieve that information? That's what we will see it in the after we complete your AJAX topic. So there's a method, there's the XML HTTP request method. So we will see how do you receive data from the server, and how do you put data to, how do you send the data, get and put the data to your servers using XML HTTP requests, or your even the JSON also, JSON files. How do you make it receiving and sending the data to your servers? So this particular information, I just keep it aside for time being, but have an idea about that it is possible for you to receive as well as send data to and from the servers through your JSON and through your XML formats. So this is one I was just telling, the using AJAX topic, we'll be able to receive the data from the server, and you need to understand how do you parse the data and how do you make the data to be manipulated on your client side. That can be done. So let us see, you know, these three slides, I keep it aside. I will get back to these three slides, because these three slides is going to be continued after our JSON topic is basically the jQuery and AJAX topics are over. So let us see the what are JSON objects. To access an object value, we use the book.title. That's what the member operator. You can specify the values and you can start using those values. So loop through object properties and you can see that properties or the key or the attributes values and assign the corresponding values in your programming structures. Let us see one of the examples before we go on to this other topics of this JSON arrays. So let me just show you here. Okay, now let us see here carefully. This is an example just now last week and in the beginning of the session I was referring to regarding the XML representation of this books data. So the same thing, if you want to represent in the form of JSON, the same thing you can see here. So let me just put it aside for you to have a comparison between these two. So now let us see I just kept the XML file and your JSON file next to each other. So in the XML file, you are using the tags. Basically, your open tags and your closing tags have been used here. So in the XML file, you are using your data representation with the help of your tags. So, but whereas if you see on the left side, this is basically your JSON representation with the same example. So you have here the parent here for this example is the bookstore. So the bookstore is an object. So it contains, you are putting this particular set of book values as an array here. So there is a open square brace and a corresponding closing brace. But in between, you can see this, these are the multiple values which are being given in this particular bookstore using your JSON. So where this particular book is an object, so that book object has got certain attributes. Those are basically your keys. So each key of that corresponding book is being given the corresponding value. So here, so the author is Eric and the year is 2003 and the price is $33.25. So you are giving the same information which you has represented in XML. You can see it on the right side. This is the same information which is represented in the form of tags. So here in the left side, if you look to the second book title is Learning Python. Similarly, on the right side, you can see the XML tags here. On the left side, again, you can see the third book and the corresponding in terms of tags. So the left side, you have the key values, the attribute and this corresponding values. So which is more advantageous here? Of course, already I have given the answer. Let me hear from you. Of course, both these structures, both these forms are representing the hierarchical manner. It means the information is organized in a hierarchical structure. So here the bookstore is the parent. Under the bookstore, you have a child book. You have another child book. And again, you have another child book. So there are three child here. And for each child, you have another level, which they corresponds to the corresponding attributes or the characteristics of those books. In the right side also, you can see the XML file, where this is also a hierarchical representation where your books information is stored in terms of parent and child relationships. That's what we are saying. We understood what is a parent-child relationship. And for each child, again, there is a corresponding characteristics which are being given in terms of tags. So may know the reason which is going to be more efficient or more better way of this storage as well as for accessing or exchanging the information. Both are meant for storing the information. Both are meant for exchanging the information. But let me tell you, in the last decade, people are very much using or this XML is very much is in use. But since for the last 4 or 5 years, this JSON format is being used as a more appropriate way for storing as well as for exchange of data between the web applications and between the web resources, which is more efficient than XML. Can I hear something from you? What may be the reason behind when the data is stored or structured like this in the JSON format? as in the object format here, the object containing key value pairs.
Sir, because the JSON is faster, we don't need to parse it in order to get the data.
You need to parse it in order to get the data. That's what your answer is, please.
Yes.
See here, once again, I will tell you here. The main reason is already the information I have given to you. The reason for this is the answer is basically this. But what can be this? The answer is here. JSON is a lightweight data interchange format. Lightweight. That lightweight is the advantageous one. People preferring for this lightweight. What is that lightweight is? That's what I like.
Every element value type is considered as string, sir. String inside the double quotes in JSON. Whereas in XML, price should be a number. Basically, XML is semantically straight. JSON is not.
Semantically straight. Because if you remember the XML examples, I have given you, you can also declare, that's what document type, you need to specify the type, whether it is a real value or whether it is a string value also. You can, using your schema structure definition, you can specify what the data types of those values can be. Your answer is, we need not specify the data types here. Everything is a string value. That's what your idea is, your meaning is?
Yes, sir.
I cannot say that is wrong answer, but I even at the same time, I cannot say the correct answer. Why? Because this answer, what you are given, something is revolving around data type. That is what I can give you the hint here. A lightweight. What is the meaning by lightweight here? Yes, please.
Sir, the size is small.
The site is?
Size of the data is small because we are adding starting tag, ending tag for the JSON that is not there.
This is not the size. Size, if it is long, which one is long here, according to you?
XML.
XML is longer. In what way it is long? Can you please tell me?
Because we are using starting tag and ending tag for each data.
Yeah, so yes, you are on the tag. Now if you see one of the main differences is here you are using something tags here. Tags are basically some types of delimiters for your data to be begin and for a data to be end. So here, of course, now you tell me you are on the track now. So in XML we use this tags, but you are not using tags here. So what does it mean? Tags, if you add tags, it becomes more lengthier. That's what your friend is telling. Of course, if you see both the representation, these are both are human readable. Human readable, machine understandable. Machine can understand both the representations. Machine means your software engines and your processing elements where your data is being exchanged between those web applications and web pages. So left side is JSON and right side XML. Both humans, we can read it, we can write it easily, but the efficient one is JSON, which is more which is basically a lightweight for interchange. So what does it mean? Still I'm giving the I'm giving some hints for you.
So less tags means less data to be processed by the system.
Less tags. There is no tag here actually in the JSON. It means the processing is less. That's what you mean to say?
Yes, sir.
The thing here is, of course, the tags is not there here, but
in XML parsing is difficult. In JSON parsing.
So here, basically, if you see here, this is a nested array. Of course, both are in the hierarchical structure as a nested array. But the XML parsing in XML is going to be a little bit difficult than your JSON. So parsing is the most important. That is a technical term. You need to use it here, basically. So here the parsing, what is meant by parsing again? I have asked the same thing on the last week also. What is meant by parsing?
Syntactical way of representation, valid syntactical representation.
Whether is the syntax is valid or not, that the process of checking the syntax validity is going to be basically your parsing. So here, that's why if you are now in this example, just only just a few 20 lines of codes are there in both the sides. But what happens is, please remember, when you are developing a web application, it will be hundreds and thousands of lines of data representation, data storage is going to be there, and the data exchange has to take place. And all these things, the parsing is going to be very non-trivial task. So you are because your JavaScript, which is this JSON is a subset of the JavaScript, that parsing is going to be very much easier as compared to XML parsing. That's why people, even for IoT, Internet of Things, and all our web communications nowadays, the JSON is most preferable format. And another thing is that you need to look for is amount of the number of tools that are available. Because this left side one, the JavaScript tools, there are many, a lot of tools are available to prepare your data and to store it and to exchange it. Whereas XML, it is not that many user-friendly tools are available for you to prepare and organize it. So is about the actually one basic difference. Can anybody tell me? We are seeing simply looking. Simply looking to these both the files. Can anybody tell me what is the simple, straightforward definition comes or straightforward interpretation comes here?
JSON seems more related to JavaScript and XML seems more related to HTML.
Okay, good. So in this direction only, let me give the answer. See, XML is indicating as a document. This is like a document. Please remember here. XML, what you are seeing, this XML file is basically called as a document. Whereas on the left side, this JSON is talking about
object
means what does it contain?
Data.
Very good. So this JSON is talking about the data, whereas XML is talking about the document. So that is, you can see the difference here. Basically, it is about the document. XML is all about the document that is getting prepared and that is getting stored and exchanged, whereas this JSON is all about talking about the data itself, which is very much clear to a subset of your JavaScript. So that is the some of those differences here. So let us write some small program. Of course, this is the difference. Let us, when you receive and send the data from the server, once our AJAX and JSP have started, I will come back to this XML and JSON again in the later stages. That's what I was telling to you. So how do you send the data and how do you receive the data? That particular task is pending for you. Once AJAX and server side scripting is started, then we will come back to that particular topic. So keep these points in mind at this juncture. So let me run some small programs for you and see how we can make an understanding. So can anybody tell me what is this script which has been shown on my screen? Can anybody describe to me, please? Hello, is my screen visible to you?
Yes sir, it's visible.
Yeah. So this is just simply an HTML file, where in this HTML file, I have just written a small script here. This script is nothing but, let me interact with you at this point. So Ali Akbar, Ali, are you online?
Yes, sir.
So can you please tell me what is this code is about, or what is this up to this seventh line? What is this file is showing to you? What is that indicating to you?
So it's simply a HTML document which has a paragraph tag with ID demo.
Very good. So this is an HTML script, means your HTML tags have been used for this script file. Why do we write means exclamation mark document type HTML as the first instruction, Ali?
So that the browser can parse it properly.
Yes, absolutely correct. Anybody else, please? Any other answers? Amritesh Kumar, can you please tell me why we write this?
So that the browser can know whether it is a HTML file, sir. It is an HTML.
Yeah, of course. It is to inform to the browser that the following set of lines are basically HTML codes. I do accept that, but I'm expecting a very right and a straightforward answer.
Latest version of HTML.
Yes, the latest version. That is HTML. HTML number?
HTML 5.
Yeah. So this I told in my previous classes. So please do keep remembering them. Do not forget it. Fine. Very good. So okay. Now this is a simple script file. Now what is there is a script tag here in this HTML file. So the script definition is something like this. Are you able to see the script now? The same thing what we have seen just now in the you have this file here with you, the JSON file. So this is what the JSON file, this is XML file. I have just shown you the JSON file here for you. Yeah, this is the JSON file. The same thing, this entire JSON, I am just keeping them under the script tag. So the script tag is this. So here in the script tag followed by your JavaScript only it implies. So you have created two objects. Of course, these are two variables, books and these titles. Of course, the title is here. This is a variable here, title. But here, this title is different. This title is basically the key value of this particular book itself. So there are two books here, one with the title Learning XML and followed by the author Eric and year 2023. Okay. And the price is this. So now the book is another one, Core Servlets and JavaScript by the two authors, and this is the price. So now, are you clear with this script, whatever I'm showing here at this moment?
Yes, sir.
Yes, please. So Lakshmi Narayana.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please. Can you please tell me what is this statement is doing here, the document.getElementById?
Yes, sir. In the parameter tag, we gave ID as demo. So using the for that tag, value will be set by this statement. And the value will be core servlet and Java server pages space 2015 as per the code written, script written here.
Of course, you have run the program and you have given me the output directly. That is fine.
Yeah. I mean, that line, what it does is sets the value for ID demo using the.
It is not setting the value for the demo. See here, you need to explain like this place. See here. So this is the document. The document is referring to the current web page. Okay. That is the current document. That document dot get element by ID. So there is an element on that web page. Which element is that you are referring to by ID? That by ID, the tag has got certain ID here. So that ID is equal to demo here. In this web page, there is only one ID, of course. So this is referring to this particular ID value, demo. Okay. So you are referring to this paragraph. And what is this inner HTML is referring, please?
Yeah, in between that P tag, P end and beginning and end, whatever the value that we want to set, we can pass that value to this inner HTML.
Okay, acceptable. Your information is correct. But what is this inner dot inner HTML is referring to?
It is the property of that
property.
P tag.
Very good. Okay, very good. So it is a property of that particular element you are referring to here, which is equivalent to, very good, thank you. So now it is done. So you are going to put that particular title. So the title is basically, your title is equal to book title. And so here basically what is that you understood is, you have represented your book's information in the JSON format. That is the most important thing here for you to understand at this point. The point there is, the JSON format representation of data is given here. And there is a script file you have written to access this particular value. So this value, which is nothing but your title, the title which is coming from book.title here. So similarly, it is also, you are going to append that particular result with this another value, that is book.year. So when you save it, and of course, this is the end of the script and the end of the body and the end of the HTML file. So now once you save it and you, let me just, I'll just change a value for you to understand here, book title. This year I'm making something like this, for you to just to have clarity here. Okay, I've saved it and I'm going to run this particular file. Object example course or let's say there's a year 2025 is now been updated, but that value is coming from which one? From a JSON object. The JSON object is this. So this is how you are going to access your JSON wise values into your script files through your JavaScripts. Let me move on to this next topic here. So we have come to, of course, this accessing the data from the server is what is pending. I'll definitely cover, because until unless you don't cover the AJAX and the server side scripting, this particular topic will be very new to you. So I don't want to make confusion, or it will be unclear for you at this moment what is server side programming and how the communication should happen between the client and the server. But let us complete this JSON and we'll come back to this JSON and XML once our server side scripting server. So we can access the array values by using the index number. That's what we have seen here. So you can write it in your JavaScript and you can put it in the loop and you can put all the, like this, whatever the example I've shown you, just one document.getdemo.net. If you want to display all the author names of the corresponding title, so you can get these values here. You can modify and delete the array values as well. So you can refer to this for your more information to get more other things. And also, I would like to share this one of this another important jsonquerytool.com. So this JSON query tool will always help you to prepare your JSON files, and at the same time, how do you query the JSON file? Using the dollar object, that is what you are a jQuery object, that you are going to see it in the next class or the next week. So this particular thing also will refer to this in the next. Once you complete the jQuery, you will understand how do you access this particular JSON values using the jQuery. So without writing this, you can also practice it using jsonquerytool.com. As far as the assignment is concerned, you can refer to this. I have given some exercises on JSON, which are mostly similar to your XML. Only thing, I just changed the format to JSON. So in the last exercise, you will have XML. Here in this one, you will have only JSON, please. So here, of course, I sell the XML, which you might have completed in the exercise 4. So in exercise 5, you have to compulsorily do the JSON file and display the data in the tabular data form. Any queries here, please? Any doubts? No?
Yes, sir. One question regarding week 4 exercise. First exercise in week 4, that is downloading the reading the XML file. So do we need to use any web server, or can we use that XML content in the script itself hard coded, like you have you are hard coding JSON script, right?
Yes, at this moment we have not discussed about any web server so far, so I'll be starting in most likely this web server topic in the next week. After 2 weeks you'll be starting. See, I am going according to this syllabus sheet. Do you have the syllabus copy with you?
Yes, sir, we have.
So you can refer to this syllabus. So here, what happened is, in the syllabus itself, so we have the unit, first unit, we have the HTML and CSS, HTML forms and CSS. Then we went to the discussion on the JavaScripts and the DOM. Then we have started the unit number 3 with the XML. And of course, the introduction to JSON is also there required. So the, actually the server-side scripting or the server-side programming is in the unit number 5. If you see as per the syllabus. So I cannot jump directly from your JavaScript to server-side programming at this point. So, but nevertheless, we will come back to this about this. That's what I told XML and JSON. Once we complete the accessing the data, once we complete this AJAX, and of course the jQuery, after 2 weeks we'll be anyway coming to this, and we come back to this XML and JSON from the web server rather than from the in the frame same file. So in this example, what you have seen is I have put this particular thing, the books information, everything on the same file, and I'm accessing those things. Similarly, you can put the same thing for the XML too.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any other queries, please? As far as the assignments is concerned, of course you have completed the assignment 1 and assignment 2 and assignment 3. So only assignment 4 are pending for us to start. So your assignment 3 is also, most of the 51 students have completed already. Of course the 72 number is not that, because already 10 students you said that they have not registered. So it most likely this will be around 56, 57 only. Don't compare this. So almost all students except 4 or 5 students. So please remember, those 4 or 5 students, if you are unable to submit, please let me know. Don't wait for the last minute, means until the end of the semester. Yeah, I would like to see some of your these marks that you obtained here. And if you have any queries, please let me know. So if you look to your assignments evaluation, I'm just randomly picking up here as such. So I just pick up the Vikas Kumar. Yes, please.
Yes, that. Week four, question number 2, and there is a one doubt that you want us to pass that search keyword in via the URL parameter, and we will catch that in some separate file, and we will search from the XML. It will be like that.
Okay. What you have said is absolutely correct. Okay, can you see the question here once again?
Yes, sir.
So you can use your HTML, CSS, of course, and your JavaScript, okay? Like your XML coding you have done here. So you are going to prepare a text box, like a search box, that what you have done in the assignment number 2. Yeah, so similar to that, that is a text box actually, right? So whatever you enter there, hello.
Yes, sir. Listen.
So whatever you enter into the text box, using your can you understand this? See here carefully. What is this meaning of the sentence? Can you what is the meaning of the statement? Can you understand this?
Yes, sir.
So you have to prepare a query. Query means a statement to search for a value.
Okay.
Are you have you understood this question here carefully?
Yes.
you have to prepare a query, whatever that is entered in the text box, that a query statement will be prepared. And that based on that query statement, you have to retrieve the data from the XML. XML data has to be retrieved based on that query. It is something similar to this. If you see the web, any web page, okay, let me just show you one example here. Okay, now see here carefully. Can you see my URL, please?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so what is written on the URL? Of course, don't see this encrypted, but you just see this value here.
Yes, that's
why. See here, you carefully, this Q is equal to weather plus in plus Hyderabad. This is the key, is basically the query statement, which is going for the search value, the search page, which is present in this server, google.com. On that server, there is going to be a search page, and for that search page, the query is given with this weather in Hyderabad. Have you understood this question, please?
Yes, yes.
Of course, you need not fetch the value here, you just make it ready so that once your Ajax and your Java server pages are over, finally by the end of the semester you can submit that particular fetching the actual value. At present you just prepare that statement and give that statement. You need not completely execute that value.
Okay.
Okay. Am I clear to you, please?
Yes, sir, clear.
Any other queries, please? Any other queries? I'll be online anyway, so if you have any queries, you please put forward. I'll just mute myself, the video and the audio, I'll mute it. So if you are just putting forward the questions, I will try to get back to you again.